a simple and improvised pulley like this, or a pulley system like this, has three helpful functions. The first thing is redirecting the force, the second thing is reducing the friction, and the third thing is you need less force to lift or move something. In my opinion, every ambitious bushcrafter should know the advantages of such a pulley. In this video, I will show you my favorite way how you can craft such a pulley with a Swiss Army knife. I will explain you the three advantages of a pulley. And in the last part, I try to measure how much mechanical advantage such a pulley system can provide you. Hello YouTube! Welcome to another Swiss Army Knife project video. Today's topic are pulleys like this. Last Friday I uploaded a video where I made a gravity rotisserie. So the idea of this machine was to bind a stone to a rope, throw the stone with the rope over a branch, and the weight of the stone should give the power to turn the axis. The problem was that the rope with the stone on the end made so much friction over the branch that the rotisserie didn't work. So I decided to make a pulley, and with the pulley the rotisserie worked perfect. And this was my eye-opener how important it can be to know how to craft a pulley. So in the first part I will show you how I craft my favorite type of pulley with a Swiss Army knife as only tool. In the second part, I explain you the three advantages of a pulley. And in the last part, I try to measure how much mechanical advantage such a pulley system can provide you. So now let's talk about the advantages of a pulley or a pulley system. A simple pulley like this with a single wheel has the main advantage that it can redirect the force. Let me explain you what this means. So if I want to lift this lock direct with the rope with a straight back out of my knees, I have to lift it like this. So, and as you could see, I don't just have to lift the lock, I also have to lift my upper body and my head with my legs. And this is not really efficient. But if you can put the rope around a hanging pulley, the whole physics are going to change. Because right now, you can pull down the rope instead of lift it. And you can use your body weight as counterweight to lift the lock. And you don't have to lift your body weight with the legs. So look at this. This is much easier. The second big advantage of such a pulley is that this pulley can reduce the friction enormous. Because like this, it's much easier to lift the lock than if I throw the rope direct over the branch, like this. So now, I have to pull much more. If you want to make a pulley system with a mechanical advantage, you need two of these rolls. The first step you have to do is to fix the rope on the branch. Like this. Second step is to fix the second pulley on the lock you want to lift. Go around with the rope. Go around the wheel from the second pulley, like this. And now it's super easy to lift the lock. So this pulley system works similar to a bicycle with different gears. If you need half the amount of force to lift the lock, you have to make twice the way with the rope. The trick is that the amount of force I pull here gets splitted through these two legs. Because here is the same tension and here is the same tension. And here on this rope I have the same tension as on these two ropes together. And this makes that I need half the amount of force to lift the lock, but I have to make twice the way with the rope. And yes, the question is allowed, in which bushcraft situation can I use such a pulley or such a pulley system? And yeah, probably this is not often the case, but if you want to lift or to move a heavy stone or a big lock, or if you want to make a pot hanger system, or I don't know. It's good to know that this kind of pulleys works. And you can learn a lot of physics, and it's a fun project to make. Now I want to try to measure in kilograms how much power or how much strength I can save with such a system or with a single pulley. For that I have such a scale. And now I zero it and pull on the scale. So, and I guess this is exactly 11 kilograms. Now I measure the strand I need when I go direct over the branch. So I zero it. So this scale wasn't able to measure it because this part is at the very end. So this is for sure more than 22 kilograms. Now I try to measure the strand I need in kilograms to lift the log with a single pulley. Okay. So this is a bit less than 16 kilograms. So my friends, these are more or less the results I expected. I hope this was an interesting video for you. I hope you could learn something. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and see you next Friday. Ciao.